up, y'all? It's your girl, and I'm back for another mukbang. Today, we're gonna be eating some food from... So, I ordered from this place called Crawfish Station. I believe it's called Crawfish Station. I have a frozen lemonade. Mm. I have some gumbo that I've already started eating here. Yeah, let's get into that. I'm gonna try to do this. I ordered extra. That's corn and potatoes, Cajun potatoes. So good. Okay. But butter and my garlic butter right here. All right, I'm trying to do this where it doesn't make a big mess. Try being Mickey word. Okay, so then I got me some shrimp that looks like there is a sausage in here, some potatoes, and a corn. So I'm gonna get in with my sauce here. I'm gonna put my sauce in it. Garlic sauce. That looks really good. Oh, you guys can't see this, huh? So they sent me some seasoning. Oh, it's spicy. It's good. Oh yeah, honey. Get in there with that. Like regular butter. Shoot, pour that on there too. Hey. Super delicious, look at that. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna try to adjust this so you guys can see. This is so good. Okay. So hungry, guys, so I'm gonna get into here and then we're gonna start talking. That's where it's at. Ooh, got a whole bite leaf in here. So, what I wanted to say was, I wanted to come and talk to you guys today about baby daddies in general. Not anyone in particular, I should say co-parenting. There's a trash can right here. Co-parenting, and because people, I actually get asked this question a lot about, you know, how I co-parent. You know, being that I have more than one baby dad, how I co-parent, what that looks like, do they pay child support, do they see their kids? This is so good. So basically, my relationship with all my baby dads are actually good. Even my ex. It didn't always start out that way. We weren't always like that. But I think over the years we kind of figured it out, and that's with, I'm talking about with all of them. Like I said, it didn't all happen at the same time, and it didn't all happen overnight. But I can honestly say that right now, I'm cool with all of them. Okay? Now, so well. I can honestly say, so as far as communication goes, I talk to all of them, you know, regularly, of course, because of the kids. We just recently moved, as a lot of you guys know, to Texas. So, we are away. So we don't live near them, any of them, but even before we didn't live with them, even before we didn't live near them, but they all come and visit. So, and I don't record it. I usually don't record it. But it's not all the time, but it is, but they definitely do come see the kids. You guys have seen Kaya's dad. He's very active. He tries to make all holidays, special occasions, and in between time to come out and see Kaya, pick her up, and they do their thing. They all talk on the phone all the time. My older kids can just call their dads. You know, I don't have to really be in charge of that, which is good. And you know, like I said, we didn't always start out this way. I didn't always have a good relationship with my baby dads. And I didn't always have help with the kids. But I could say now, we're on a good page. Just because you're not in the same state does not mean you can't co-parent, you know? I think a lot of people think that in order to be a good parent, you have to be in the same state. A lot of you guys know, I have a son, Cash, who lives in Colorado with his dad. But I do have split time with him, so he does come and stay with me half the time. And I consider myself a damn good parent, even though I'm not there every day. So, does it hurt me to not be with him every day? Hell yes. Is it stressful sometimes? Yes. Hell, even depressing sometimes, but I do my best. Nobody can say that I don't. To make sure that he knows that we're here, we didn't forget about him, the kids are outside playing. And I go see him, or I will go get him and bring him to where we're at. I'm actually gonna go get him pretty soon. So I'm excited about that. Well, that's just an example of how I co-parent a child that's not in my state, you know? You know, it's possible. They had a frozen lemonade. I mean, they had frozen Kool-Aid on their menu. Girl, I had to give me one. It's so good. You guys remember being a kid and making your own frozen lemonade, and making your own frozen Kool-Aid and putting your Kool-Aid in the refrigerator and letting that thing slush up a little bit? It is so good, y'all. And they put a lot of sugar in it too, like black folks like to do. Yes, honey. Can't go out right now because it's Corona, but that don't stop nothing, okay? The show still must go on. The show must go on. But yeah, so basically, my kids, they don't all get to see their dads weekly or daily, but they do see them. They do have a relationship with them, and they do pay child support. Now, the next part I want to talk about is not all my baby dads are on child support. Reason being is because when I put them all on around the same time, and the time that I put them on was a time where I wasn't getting any help, I wasn't getting any act right, and I don't regret doing it. You know, do it if you gotta do it. At first, I wasn't even gonna put them on child support. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, it didn't always start out that way, y'all. At first, I didn't want to put anybody on child support because I was like, what am I going to get from nothing? You know, what am I going to get? If they don't want to, I don't want to chase anybody to be a dad or to take care of their kid and make the system make them take care of their own kid. It doesn't make sense to me. You know. My mom told me, like, even if they're not working right now, even if, you know, you don't communicate with them right now, put them on anyway, because one day they're gonna have to grow up and work or whatever. So you need to make sure you head out for the babies. So I went ahead and put them all on, right? Like I said, it wasn't always an easy ride. And then, you know, as time went on, I started getting more from them. And then, you know, I talked to a couple of them and I was like, you know, they came to me and asked. And I was like, yeah, you know, as long as you can do what you're supposed to be doing, for you know, our child or children, I don't have a problem with that, because I'd rather handle this without the system anyway. And you know, so I did what I had to do to take them off, and we have a setup. Automatically every month I get support for the kids. And nothing changed. Nothing changed. The only thing that changed is having an order from a judge saying that they had to do that. Now, all of that is gone and it's just us co-parenting. And that's the way it's really supposed to be. You know, child support is good when you need it. It's good when you don't, when you have somebody who doesn't want to help and you have to force them to help. Or it's also good sometimes when you just cannot communicate with somebody, you know, because I honestly got tired of asking too. Like, I got tired of asking some of them. I'm like, I'm tired of asking y'all. You know, I'm tired of asking you for stuff over and over and over when I need something. So child support was easier for that. But like I said, people grow up, they mature, and it becomes a different situation. You don't have to go through that, you know? Now, some of them are still on support, and I think it's just easier for us that way. It's been like that for years. It's like, you know, it's just easier. Look at this corn, y'all. Oh, so good. So good. So, okay, my camera died, so we're gonna finish this up on my phone. But yeah, y'all. Basically, that's that. I'm happy with the way things are right now between me and our dads. I thought this is the way it was always supposed to be, so you know, that's kind of what it is. I'm even cool with the girlfriends and the wives and all of that. Like, it's all cool, and that's the way it's supposed to be. Like I said, it wasn't always like that, y'all, okay? I've had my fair share of baby mama drama with the baby daddies. But now we're grown past it. We've learned how to co-parent. And that's all that matters. Because at the end of the day, it's about the kids. You know what I'm saying? That's all it's really about. Forget all the other stuff. I won't go into how much I get from them or anything like that, because that's really none of y'all's business. But I will say it's enough to help, but it's definitely not enough to make me rich. Okay? Like, I can't quit my job and just live off of that. It wouldn't work. I will tell you though that I put a portion aside for all the kids' savings. That's really important to me. To make sure they have a little something. I'm not sure if I'll be able to afford a college education for all of them, cash, but I can say that they'll have a good start when they get older. So yeah, that's really important to me. So I put some of that aside for that, and then the rest goes into what they need, a little bit of what they want, and you know, their expenses. That's basically how I handle that. I'm trying to think what else people always ask me about as far as baby daddies. I think the biggest thing is like, do they see them? And the answer is, like I said, they do see them. It's not every day. And some of them we haven't seen in like a year just because of work schedules and like where we're located at. But that doesn't stop FaceTime, it doesn't stop calls, it doesn't stop, you know, other interactions. So while there may not be a dad physically in the house, all my kids know their dad and they have a relationship with them, which is important. You know, at this you know, I don't live a fairy tale life. It's not a fairy tale. It's not a perfect situation, but I want to make sure I make the best of our situation. So, I mean, what else more can I ask for? Onyx woke up, so here he is, but I am full. I can't really eat anymore. I ate mostly all of this, but there's a few shrimps and some sausage. I'm gonna have to eat that later because I'm like really, really full right now. And I want to have room for this frozen Kool-Aid because it's delicious. You know, we're working it out. So if you're going through your own thing, it'll work out, okay? It will work out eventually. Get this out the way. It'll work out eventually. Just hang in there, stay strong. You know, if you could work it out without the system, do that. If you can't, use it as a last resort. But get what you gotta get, you know, as long as you're doing what's best for you and yours. I consider myself doing the best I can. I know I get a lot of scrutiny. I'm sure there's gonna be people in the comments with a lot to say, but you know what? I can't help it. I'm doing the best I can for me, okay? And for this little one and all these other little ones. All right, y'all, I'm gonna get out of here. Thank you for joining me on this mukbang. If you guys want me to talk about something else in another mukbang, drop it below, DM me, whatever. And I will see you guys next time. Say bye, Onyx. Bye-bye.